Welcome to Guns and Chicken Strips. I'm your host, James. What's happening? It's a magnet fishing kind of day, but first, we're going to do some regular fishing. I'm here with my buddy, Nick. He was nice enough to bring me out here. We are on Lake Worth. Supposedly, there used to be a casino out here. If anybody knows about that, put that in the description. Tell me what it was called, all that good stuff, because I want to know. There was an old casino, an old amusement park. So later on, we're gonna be busting out these bad boys over where the casino and the amusement park used to be. And it was run by gangsters. So we're gonna try to find some murder weapons and stuff like that. But right now, we're just gonna hit up some fishing over here under these docks, try to catch some bass. We'll see what happens. Let's get this first cast out here of this beautiful morning. It's my first time fishing in like 6 months.
Really?
Yep. No, not 6 months. Sorry, like 3 or 4 months.
I'm glad I had the honors to help you.
I know, right?
You need to move that reel over. I don't know if you're right or lefty.
I'm right.
You're righty?
Well, I'm how it is. I don't even know if I'm left or right-handed, but I'm however it is.
However it is, it's fine.
Yeah. Texas! You know those times. Everybody has them on the lake, but this lake does not have a marina, so sometimes you gotta bite the bullet, you know, and you gotta do something that you just don't like doing, but you just have to do. Get back with you guys and gals a little bit later. Well, supposedly that's part of the old casino right over there. I don't know if you can see it, the rock thing right there. It's always so crazy to see old stuff like that. Imagine how much work somebody put into that for it to just be sitting there like that. But it's pretty cool anyway. I've never actually been on this lake. This is my first time, but it's a pretty nice little lake, you know. I've heard it's not that great for fishing, but everybody has a different opinion about lakes. I like it. It's pretty. It feels great out here. Take advantage of it before it gets freezing cold. Damn, Nick, you're kicking my butt.
How you doing, son?
First fish in the boat, though.
Hey, this is what they look like, you know that?
Yeah.
I didn't know if you... Oh, I was just showing you, because I know your fishing skills.
So. My fishing skills are very minimal.
Yeah, I just want to show you what they look like.
Mine that I almost caught, though, was about twice that size.
Uh-huh. He was this big.
He was huge.
Massive. Need help? Put it back.
Apparently we spun the nut, spun the lower unit on here, hub.
Yeah.
It's just a little rubber bushing.
Yep.
Yeah, so now we're just gonna cruise back because we can't go full speed, and we're gonna magnet fish at that old casino over there to not risk getting stuck out here on the lake. Right?
Yep.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, this unfortunate event has happened to us.
It happens. That's owning a boat, man. Every damn time, I swear. Such the life of a boat owner. We're just cruising, you know, idling as fast as we could go out here on Lake Worth.
3.1 miles an hour, to be exact.
3.1 miles per hour. Still gonna be a good day, though. He's caught a fish. I almost caught a fish. And we're gonna go back over here and we're gonna do some magnet fishing. So it should. I'm thinking it's gonna turn out to be a good day. Or that just may be the positive person inside of me.
I'm still having fun.
Yeah, I'm so relaxed, dude. Well, 2 hours later.
Whatever, 39 minutes.
39 minutes. You just ruined that whole thing.
That's all right, but we need to be realistic now. 2 hours.
39 minutes later, we're a whole 200 yards past where we were. Go 2.6 miles per hour. Yeah. But it's all good. Feels amazing outside. The clouds in this beautiful Texas sky are nice. And we're almost there. I'd say we're about half a mile from where our destination is, with the old casino. So stay tuned. I just want to show y'all a little something that I worked on a few weeks ago that didn't turn out very well. That's why I didn't put it in a video. Everybody was messaging me saying I need to put Plasti Dip on these things, and I did, but but it just did not turn out how I had expected or and or planned. So it looks kind of janky, but I think it'll help in the overall, you know. We got the two 500 pounders. Go for the inaugural toss here. Just give it a little drop, drop, droppy off the side. Don't get it near your phone or wallet. Just FYI, Nick. While he's still fishing here, I'm just gonna bob it across the bottom here, see if we can grab anything on the way. Oh, I think I got something, Nick.
See.
Definitely heavier. Oh man.
Man,
piece of metal. No, it's
a, like a stick?
No, it's like a spike.
Cool.
Shotgun barrel. It's a shotgun barrel. Alright, let's keep going. Let's find some more stuff. What'd you get, Nick?
I think I've got something. Let's see. Oh yeah. What is it? It's a pin.
Hey, look at that.
Two nails. Two old nails, too. That's a really old nail. Look at that.
Yeah.
And look this old pin, though. What that thing is
bad. That's interesting.
Yeah, it is. Look at that.
It's like brass.
Copper. Yeah, it's brass. Huh. Hmm. That's weird.
Yeah.
Oh, it's got a weird tip to it.
Oh, keep it. Hmm. Gotta find. Nice. Your first magnet. Your first magnet fishing finds. How do you feel?
Great.
You feel great?
Yes. I mean, I think this is going to be successful. I'm going to be a millionaire.
I know, right?
By the end of the day.
This is what I was talking about earlier. If you could see this rock formation, there used to be a casino and an amusement park right here on this lake, somewhere right around here, according to local folklore. So, hopefully, we find some cool stuff. I got my magnet just dragging over there. It's going to be a good day. We're just going to keep on rolling with this.
Already caught some fish.
Already he caught some fish. I have caught absolutely nothing but that steel rod.
No, you caught a fish that fell off.
Yeah, I caught a fish that I didn't get on camera, but I didn't get on the boat, so it doesn't count.
Just keep on it so I can get a scratch on top
of it. That ain't moving. It's probably in the ground. Yeah. I think it came off.
I don't think it's gonna come out, dude. Clean your magnet off so it sits flat.
Nah, I ain't worried about it.
What is it?
Piece of metal. With electrical tape around it. What the hell could that be? That's weird. It's a piece of metal with electrical tape around it. I got something else. What is it?
I don't know what that is, but...
I don't know. Some sort of backing or something.
Nice.
Nick was 100% sure we were gonna find a murder weapon out here. But we just didn't, you know, and I'm trying to explain to him, that's just the way the cookie crumbles sometimes. It's just the way it happens, you know. Sometimes you find a whole bunch of random garbage, sometimes you find a little bit of random garbage, and every once in a while you find something awesome. Some dude this week posted in a magnet fishing Facebook club that I'm a part of. I feel so fancy. Boasted that he found a 357 Smith & Wesson revolver. It was pristine. Man, it was a beautiful pistol. That got me just pumped. And that's why I came out here today and tried to, you know, get on some. But you win some, you lose some, and sometimes you just ride the middle. And today, we were riding the middle. I was losing most of the morning, but then I rode the middle. What?
Like a NASCAR race.
NASCAR race.
Yep.
Just going in circles. But it's been a beautiful day. It was cold this morning, but not too cold. And it warmed up and it felt really nice. The beautiful sky. Sun is shining. Shining down on my face. But I love it, guys. Well, Nicholas.
We tried.
It was fun. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you, buddy.
We made good decisions, man.
We tried.
Yeah. We tried. We did good, man.
It's good to caught up, though.
We found a little bit of stuff.
Yeah.
You caught some fish.
Yep.
It was a good day.
Yep.
Yeah.
I got that rare epic pin.
You got that rare, where is that pin at?
It's over here.
Let's see this pin.
It's rare and epic.
This is the find of the day right here.
Yes.
It is an Evermade.
Ever something.
Ever pin. We don't know, but it looks fancy. And he's going to try and sell it and make us rich.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, we can just buy murder weapons then.
Exactly. That's what we're going to
find
do.
Them.
Yeah. Buy murder weapons. But yeah, good to see you, man.
Good
hey,
to see you, brother.
But we'll see you later, Nick.
See
make
you.
Good decisions.
You too.
Don't hurt anybody.
Try not to.
Have fun in that awesome
call me,
truck. We are now headed over to my brother's house to give him some deer meat. Got the deer back. Kayla Jean was nice enough to go pick it up from the processor last week. Got that. Got some jalapeno and cheese summer sausage. Oh, man. And by far, my favorite, deer jerky. This stuff is, it's gold. It's gold. I love it. My brother's gonna love it. I didn't tell him I was bringing it for him. But he hasn't been able to hunt because he has two kids now. And newborn, it's just not optimum. Working too much. He's just a beast. But we're gonna go bring that over to him and see what him and the La Familia are up to. Maybe they might like some deer steak, you know? Some deliciousness. Long day, man. That freaking boat. You just tired of boat problems, man. That is the main reason I am not a boat owner anymore. That's the second time. Last two times I've gone on a boat, we've had major issues. Boats are. I'm sure most of y'all are fishermen, so y'all know how it is. But I hope y'all enjoyed this episode. I got an awesome, some cool stuff coming up next weekend. It's going to be cool. I love you guys. I hope y'all enjoyed this episode of Guns and Chicken Strips. Thank you so much for watching. You're amazing. And as always, catch you tomorrow, big chickens.